Bonneville Dam, the first federal dam built by the Army Corps of Engineers along the Columbia River in 1937. Today, there are 31 dams on the Columbia and Snake Rivers that provide clean, low-cost energy to the entire Northwest. And I'm joined today by the Army Corps of Engineers, Dave Weiss, who's going to explain to us how we start with water here, run it through the dam, and provide electricity to you and your family and the businesses that serve you. Dave?
Let's go to the powerhouse. We'll see how that happens.
Let's do it. So here we are at the powerhouse where the water and the turbines work their magic. Dave, what's going on beneath us?
Well, hydropower uses the force of falling water. We're here in the powerhouse. We're at Bonneville Dam. Water falls about 60 feet under the dam. It's the force of that falling water that turns these water wheel-like structures under the generators. Those spinning turbines, we call them, run the generator, spins a magnet in the generator that produces electricity on copper coils right below our feet. Bonneville Dam produces enough electricity for a city the size of Portland, Oregon. Once that power is produced here, the Bonneville Power Administration will distribute that power over transmission lines all over the Northwest.
So now, hydropower is a great resource. Can you tell us a little bit about the benefits of hydropower?
Certainly. Because we're using the power of falling water, we can do it again and again. Because of the water cycle, water can go through this dam, other dams, and rains and snows starts the whole process over again. Water is a renewable resource. It's also a clean resource. We're not burning anything here. There's not a byproduct pollution. So it's a fairly cheap source of electricity. We don't have to haul fuel in, and it's a fairly clean source of electricity as well.
So along with those great things that the hydro system provides us, there are challenges. Can you talk a little bit about those?
Yes, there are challenges. Dams are an obstacle to salmon. Adult salmon trying to get upstream to their spawning grounds, young salmon, baby salmon, going downstream to the ocean. Luckily, the dam was designed with fish ladders and other passage facilities for salmon, and we're always improving those facilities, whether it's screens to keep young salmon away from the turbines, or other systems to pass fish safely by the dam. We're using the latest scientific research to always improve those systems here at Bonneville Dam.
So as you can see, operating a dam is a very complex and involved process. But Dave, if you had to sum it up, what would you say is the most challenging aspect of operating a dam?
Well, I think the biggest challenge is trying to find the balance. There are all kinds of competing demands we have on this resource and finding the balance between them all. Here at Bonneville Dam, we want to use water to make electricity, but it's also important that we use this resource for improved transportation, water for boats. And of course, we must remember salmon. Salmon need water too, water for fish passage. Now there's other dams on the system that are built for flood control and for irrigation, and they're a part of finding this balance as well. Working together, the Corps of Engineers, Bonneville Power Administration, public and private utilities, all working together to get the most out of this Columbia River resource.
Thanks for joining us. We hope we provided you with a better understanding of how we harness the power of the river to bring energy to you and your family. And we hope you'll continue to join us as we examine the benefits and issues associated with powering the Northwest.